Your Berks Craftsmen on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown Folk Festival and by the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen.
Good morning on this first day of spring. I am Kay Benikoff, your host of Berks Craftsmen, and I have been honored with the task from the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen to be here today while the Berks County Intermediate Unit Art Show is being set up right here at the GoggleWorks. This is the event of the year where our guild will judge and award our Stanley G. Seltz Student Awards to those most deserving art students in Berks County. Paula Conroe, our new education chairperson, and her panel of judges from our guild will judge this event and will award first, second, third, and fourth prizes in categories of fine art, craft, and our newest category, digital design. And we have six very special awards that will also be awarded. The Burkhart Gerhart Family Award, the Hedwig Miller Fiber Award, the Ruth Ann Hartung Two Dimensional Award, the Wib Lauder Award for Best Traditional Work, and the Richard M. Loper Memorial Award. Finally, the Stanley G. Seltz Award for Outstanding Achievement in Design and Craftsmanship. You can go to our website at rbcrafts.org and learn about these individual awards and about the person whose name is on the award. Also, for these special students, everyone here is special and all these artwork is just tremendous. In the fall of 2024, we have our juried art and crafts holiday special out at the Kutztown University. We set up a student gallery out there and we invite all our winning students to participate in that event. So with no further ado, let's go find out what's happening here on the day of setup for this wonderful BCIU student art program. Hi, I'm here with Caitlin Gruber from the BCIU. She is the project specialist from BCIU, and this is her most busiest, or maybe the two most busiest days of the year, and she's going to tell us how this all starts from ground zero, right, Caitlin?
Yes. So, like we talked about earlier, we pretty much work on this all year round. We'll give ourselves a good 2.5 weeks break after this show, and we'll start planning for next year. So, we have an art committee, which makes up five teachers from around the county that help us out, and then Erica, the GoggleWorks gallery manager here, has been super helpful with us. So we all meet and just sort of go over what worked, what didn't work, what we could maybe change. We changed last year. We started doing labels. We have the teachers send us the artwork from the beginning, and then we put them on labels so it's easier when they get here. They don't have to worry about that. We just try to make it easy because the teachers put in a lot of work. The students put on a lot of work. So wherever we can help, we try to help them out.
So how many students participate, do you think, in this, approximately?
Approximately, well, there are about, on average, I'd say about 100 art pieces from each district. We have 20 districts, so.
Do the math.
Yes, right, exactly. Some are, repeat students, but there are a lot of pieces of artwork, and it is very fun to walk around and look at different pieces from the different districts in the county.
Yeah. Well, I think it's so great for the students. So, you know, rather than just being, you know, presenting it in their own area, that what I said before, I think it's just super that, you know, then all the people in Berks County get to come to one area and see all this terrificness.
Yes, right here you can see, what the students from around the county have won.
Thank you so much for talking with us today.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Christina Pinkerton, the Exeter art teacher, junior high and senior high?
Just the senior high.
Senior high, okay. And so she is going to tell us all about opening day. Well, it's not opening day, it's setup day here. So how does that go for you?
Oh, I love today. This is just so exciting to get everything coordinated, putting it up and then seeing all the other schools, and it's a fun day. You know, I really enjoy setting up for this show.
Well, you work all year for this, right?
Yes, definitely. Yeah.
Okay, well, I know all these kids like to talk to you. You know, they're not only good artists, okay? So I'm just going to pass this down. They can say their name, tell us what you do, and whatever else you want to say.
All right. Hi there, I'm Lily Damon. I am an artist at Exeter Senior High School. I really like working with acrylics, and I also really like to draw in general. I like to draw people, and I like to paint cats.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Rand Capeland. I'm a senior at Exeter, and I'm just having fun, like just enjoy doing this. I do whatever I can do medium-wise. I am all over this place, so I've done internships with the GoggleWorks before, so it's really interesting to be here and do a whole another show, because I've been in shows here before.
Hello, I'm Michaela Curry. I mainly do ceramics, and this is my first ever show I've been in, so I'm very excited with helping setting it up.
Hi, I'm Andrea Dominguez. I'm a senior at Exeter Senior High School. I mainly like to do ceramics. It's my favorite. Miss P introduced me into ceramics, and now I love it, and yeah.
Hi, I'm Liliana Magazu. I'm a senior at Exeter, and I usually do ceramics. I started last year, and Miss P got me into it too, so it's something I really enjoy, and it's really nice to be here and help set up, so yeah.
And setting up, you have a lot of work here, okay? I mean, we heard ceramics, paintings, just everything. So you're doing a good job. So I won't hold you up anymore, okay? But I will be back when the show starts on Friday, okay? And we'll be back at the award ceremony. So wish you all great luck, okay? And just have a great time.
Thank you so much.
I am here with Naomi Vogel. She is the art teacher from Boyertown. And she is super excited, I can tell. And I pulled her off that ladder, okay? So she's going to stop for a few minutes and tell us about what happens at Boyertown in getting ready for the preparation for the BCIU Student Art Show.
This is an exciting time for all of us, just gathering the artwork and being able to showcase all the wonderful talent at our school.
And we have Megan over here. She's waiting to talk to us about how the students feel about this super art show.
Just very exciting to see my work on a wall and be able to put my name out there. And I know, like, with AP this year, like, getting to see, like, the people that I know and the work that they create and get known for it and get it out there is just so, like, exciting and incredible to see how, like, I don't know, how just excited they all get. So I'll get ready to go to Reading and come out here and put it up.
Well, they'll just have to come out and view this art, okay?
Yes.
This fantastic place opens on Friday, okay?
Friday, yes.
Okay, so bring your friends and tell everyone in Boyertown to get up here.
Absolutely, yes, come on out.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And now I'm here with Twin Valleys art teacher, Addie McKerns, and her assistant, Emma. I forgot your last name, Emma. I'm sorry.
It's Ahern.
Okay, very good. Okay, so they are hanging the all this beautiful art from Twin Valley. Tell us how happy you are to be here today.
Oh, I'm very happy. So it's a great part of the year. It's pretty much, you know, it's kind of winding down. It's the end of the year. So this is so nice for our kids to be able to come here after everything's set up and see what the other schools are doing and then get their ideas for next year. It's just, it's kind of like, I don't know. It's like the grand finale of the year. So,
well, one of the other teachers said it's like the Super Bowl.
Yes, that's good. Yeah.
Well, tell us about what you've been here before, Emma, in a different capacity.
So I graduated from Governor Mifflin in 2018, and I participated here as a senior in the art show. So it's really cool to come back 6 years later and see it from the teacher perspective and all the behind the scenes and work that goes into it with everyone setting up. So I'm just really happy to be here again.
So do you want to tell us about some of these things, maybe?
Sure. This is an Art 3 project. They have to embed the words somehow in their composition, and it's black velvet paper. So we talk about how velvet paper was used in like the 60s and 70s, and then we talk about like psychedelic lettering and how it was in music and fashion and art. So the only requirement is painting on black velvet paper with tempera and trying to embed words that are kind of like easy to read but hidden. So this one, every year it's more and more. So this year now they're starting to add some 3D elements like coming out of the pieces. So every year they get better. And then this one is fiber art that threw up all over and looks amazing. And then we have copper embossing. So a little bit of everything here at Twin Valley.
I see you have a lot more yet to put up. So, okay, we're going to let you back to your work, okay, because it has to be ready by Friday.
It does.
Okay.
Thank you.
I am here with Elizabeth McCamey from Wilson School.
We love coming to the GoggleWorks. We look forward to it all year. It's wonderful to see all of the other schools and our, you know, kind of cohorts in other schools and get ideas and look at the talent that they have as well. So it's, again, something we look forward to. It's kind of the culmination other than our own art show. And it's just to celebrate the arts and the visual arts especially.
And I think, you know, I like the fact that all the school districts in Berks County are represented.
Well, it's hard for us to get together as an art teacher with Mr. Graber and Mrs. Denault, but then to see other teachers, it's so great to say, you know, what's going on in your world? You know, and otherwise we don't have that opportunity. And it's really our opus, and we're all very excited. So it's really very congenial, which I love.
Thank you. Thanks for taking time out, because I know you have so much to do here, so I'll let you get back to work.
I appreciate our principal letting us come down here. So that's, you know, the arts kind of don't have the kind of weight that some other academic subjects do. And I appreciate that he gives us some, you know, legitimacy as we, you know, to take off and come down and, you know, make it look the best we can. So that's
I totally agree, and it's looking good.
Great, thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm here with Leroy Woodward, one of the art teachers from Governor Mifflin High School, and he is so excited about hanging all this wonderful art behind us. He's going to tell us about it right now.
So we have a variety of visual arts. We have visual arts 3-4, and also AP art. So. Most of our pieces, or bigger pieces, are from our AP art students who are participating in the online portfolio. And then we have printing, we have printmaking, we have ceramics that is going to be coming in later. We have digital art, and then we also have a little bit of photography also. So painting, drawing, a little bit of everything. It's good. It's going to be a nice variety.
Okay, so do most of the students like start the school year and anticipating this art show and then working on projects?
Yeah, this is our big show for the county. Everybody's kind of gearing towards that, even with our smaller art shows, learning how to mat and present their artwork in a positive way.
Well, very good. So you had your work cut out for you, as you do every year, but
yes.
You must have the most fun job in the world.
I do, and our two other art teachers do an outstanding job of getting our kids prepared.
Okay, very good. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you.
I am here with some of the art students from Schuylkill Valley High School, and their teacher, Miss Harley, said that these are the people that I need to talk to. So we're just going to start right here with the big guy.
Hi. I mostly do black and white stuff, just pencil and then line art, but I do have one here that's like colored pencil.
And the big guy, you do have a name, right?
Yeah, Jeremiah.
Jeremiah.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, Jeremiah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Ella. I am very excited to be here to see all of the different art pieces. It's an amazing opportunity to see what the people of this county and the state have been doing. I feel like I said, it's just a wonderful opportunity. There's so many different things. Everyone's showcasing their talents, and I'm so grateful to be a part of it.
I'm Adriana Madden. Ella and I are co-presidents of our art club at Schuylkill Valley, and this is one of my drawings that I did of her. I have various pieces around here. I have ceramic, and I do a little bit of everything. And we're just really excited to be putting our stuff up. And we have a lot of excellent artwork from a lot of kids.
So what mediums do you all do, I mean, are offered at Schuylkill Valley?
Well, we do ceramics, we do portfolio, studio, almost any type of medium that you can do, we offer.
And you come up with some of your own?
Yeah, I have one that's colored pencil, and then most of them are just black and white, but that's just like the medium that I'm comfortable with.
Okay, well, thank you so much, and we'll let you get back to work, because you do have to have this all done by Friday.
Yeah.
Okay, and you can't keep getting out of school, although you might want to, right?
Yeah.
Much more fun. Thanks, guys. I'm here with Benjamin Hoffman, the art teacher from Kutztown High School, right? And Poe is with him, and they're going to tell us a little bit about how excited they are and the anticipation of just coming to this art show in Berks County.
So like I said, Ben Hoffman here at the high school, we have a really robust program. So we're a small rural town, but we pack a punch. We represent all the mediums here from watercolor, drawing and painting and sculpture. And I have a great group. These are all of our AP art students. So it's kind of letting them take the reins and really celebrate the arts in this showcase today.
It's just very fun to view all the other schools' artwork and just see all of the creativity that our peers can express through their art. And I think it's very enlightening to experience artwork outside our own district. And so I'm very excited.
Well, what do you do?
So I kind of do a lot of different mediums. My favorite is definitely oil painting, but I like to mess with mixed media. I've been exploring more textiles and sewing as a means of illustration.
So how many students participate from Kutztown in your show?
Sure. We try and represent as many of the students across our studios, you know, a smaller population, but there's probably close to 40 or 50 students represented in our show. And again, this year we have 7 students in AP who have really take the spotlight, but just kind of give a voice to everyone. Yeah, so AP is the advanced placement course for students who can take it actually as a junior or a senior, but similar to any other AP class you would take, it is the uppermost level course you can take. It's very independently driven, and I mean, Poe can speak to it. We do a lot of work. They do a lot of work, near 20 plus pieces, and they develop a portfolio, and it's a really robust program that just gives them agency and their voice to be heard.
I wanted to ask someone else that, and then we got off on another tangent. So I think that that's good to get that out there, you know, because those students are really concentrated then in the art, you know. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Take care.
I am here with the two high school art teachers, Tara Halverson and Chad Shalloway, and they are from the, as I said, Antietam School District. They are hanging all this beautiful artwork here. And I think that they're pretty excited about being here today because there is lots of artwork all over the floor here. So you have a lot of work to do. So tell me what's happening.
We're just excited to be able to be here. As you know, we had the flood and we lost both of our studios during that time. So all of our mat board and our cutters and all of our things were gone. But as we know, art heals. So even though we're at Trinity Church, we're still teaching the students. They're still creating incredible artwork. And we feel blessed to be able to be here today.
Well, we're blessed to have you here too. You know, I mean, yes, you guys really did suffer through that. And well, we just wish you all the best. And, you know, I read in the paper that things are coming along for
Hopefully.
You guys.
Yes,
yes. So I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Okay. So what mediums do you all work in?
There are some that we couldn't do this year because of the situation. Like, we don't have ceramics this year, computer graphics, printmaking. But we do have watercolor, photography, drawing, painting, 3D design, fibers.
So, and about how many students then were able to participate?
We have 135 pieces. I don't have the student count yet.
Okay, but 135 pieces.
It's 100 students minimum, yeah.
Oh, wow. So you guys pulled it together.
We tried. We're celebrating where we can, yeah.
That's cool. And you did say some fiber, and but there's just a few things that you do, obviously, because of
ceramics. Yeah. We are, you know, with folding tables and chairs at Trinity Church, and we're so grateful to even have a space. But yeah, without a kiln, without the, you know, all of those things we need, we don't have sinks in the classrooms. We're kind of filling up water buckets and doing everything we can. But our students have been so resilient and amazing, and you know,
so have their teachers.
Well,
resilience.
That's our job, but you're right. We're just so super proud of them and happy to be able to showcase their work.
We are so glad you're here, and we pray for you too.
Okay.
Appreciate
you.
Thank you.
I am here with Steve Simons and two of his students from the Reading Muhlenberg Career and Technical Center. And Steve, tell us who you brought with you today to help you hang this show.
This is Austin Forrester. He's my design intern. We hire interns at the school, so he's actually working for the school while he's actually a student there. He's a senior at Muhlenberg, and this is Joe Gold, and they're a junior at Muhlenberg.
I'm an intern at RMCTC, Reading Muhlenberg Career Technical Center. I got a piece here redesigning the Thriller album, and I got another charcoal piece of the Death Reaper gambling with cards.
I'm Joe. I designed an editorial with an article that he actually wrote, and this is a random piece that I was experimenting with typography with.
Thank you, guys, and get back to work. You only have till Friday. I am here with Kristen Overly from Topahakan. She is the high school art teacher there. She has her hands a little full, okay, because she's hanging the show. She has no help, so if anyone wants to come down and help her, she'd appreciate it.
I would love some help.
Okay, so I know you're excited about being here today, okay, and you have to hang this show all day today, right? Because it has to be done by Friday, so... But what have you been working on all year to get to this?
Well, we've been busy over in Topahakan. What I have in my hands right here, we worked on some cardboard sculptures with my Art and Design 1 students. These are some pieces that I'm pretty proud of. One of my juniors, his name's Austin Keeler, he created this Nike sneaker, which is pretty awesome because it's only made out of cardboard and hot glue. And then we have Donnie the Deer. This was made by another one of my juniors. Her name is Lydia Dye. So she created this. It hangs on the wall just like that.
Well, I like the combination of like a traditional art with the contemporary.
Yes, we do a lot of different projects in Art and Design 1 and 2 in my ceramics courses. So we try to dabble in a lot of different areas, really just focusing on elements and principles of design.
Well, I'm interested about the cardboard. I don't think I've ever seen too much of that before. Did you come up with that? Or, I mean, the art world is so open with so many different things out there.
Pinterest.
Oh.
Pinterest is a great area to get inspiration for a lot of different ideas. I was following some artists on Instagram, and we came across a few on the Modern Met who do nothing but cardboard sculptures. So we decided to do a sculpture in the style of some of the artists that are listed there.
Okay, so it's recycling in this cardboard. That's pretty cool.
That's correct. Upcycle. I'm all about it.
Thank you so much for sharing. Let me ask you one more question. So like in Topahakan then, how many art students do you have that participate in the show?
I have about 100 each semester.
Whoa, that's pretty, okay.
It's not bad for a small school.
Yeah. Okay, thank you again so much, and I'll let you get back to work.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, so we're gonna take a trip into the future now, and we're going to see the award winners from this wonderful BCIU art show, and then we're gonna go down and interview those winners and find out what they're gonna do in the future. So until then.
Welcome everyone to the Secondary Art Show Awards Ceremony. Thank you for coming out on this Sunday afternoon to join us to recognize all of the amazing talents that we have here in Berks County with our students. I'm Katie Kaim. I work for the Berks County Intermediate Unit. I have the honor and the pleasure to work with amazing people to put this together. I will say I could not do it with all the work from my colleague, Caitlin Gruber. She is our project specialist, and she's sent a million emails and has been the person to really coordinate all this. So thank you, Caitlin. I appreciate it. And to get us started, we are going to have a few words from GoggleWorks from the executive director, Levi Landis. He's going to give us some information about the GoggleWorks here.
There's a thinker and a philosopher named G.K. Chesterton who once said that gratitude is happiness doubled by wonder. Who is in wonder for our students and their work downstairs? Give me an applause for all these kids. We're going to talk a little bit more about them in a second, I promise, but I do want to thank a few people and acknowledge a few others. Again, acknowledging these students, you know, they work year-round in all kinds of fields, of course, but art is this piece that if we connect with it right, it can transform our lives, it can connect bridges, it can heal our community and help us grow. So that's what we do here. We transform lives through unique interactions with art. And I'll talk a little more about our programs here in a second. I want to acknowledge our teachers and administrators. Can you stand up or raise your hand, please? Give a hand to all the teachers, administrators, faculty. Thank you, thank you, thank you for everything you do.
Thank you, Levi. I am going to continue on with our many thanks and our gratitude here this afternoon. We have the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen with us today, as well as BCTV. And they are one of our community partners, and we wouldn't be here without their support and their help as well. We also want to reiterate the thank you to you, the amazing students who've used your creativity and your imagination to get us here today. And to the teachers, because we also wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all the amazing teachers being able to instill the art and the different techniques and strategies and allowing you to use your imagination and bring that art to life. So thank you, teachers. Also, thank you to Erica here at the GoggleWorks. She coordinated all of our judges who went through and is why we're here giving you out our first, second, third, fourth, and our honorable mentions. So thank you to all of the judges that had a role and played a part in today's event. So thank you. And another community member that we will be bringing up here shortly as well is the Berks Arts. And they provided with Redners our snacks and our refreshments in the back. So here's a list of the entire community partners that we worked with. Here shortly in the next 2 to 3 weeks, we will be meeting again to start to plan out the dates for next year. So it is a year-long event that we are working behind the scenes, but the Berks County Art Educators, parents and students, the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen, Berks Art Council, the Fast Lane Program, GoggleWorks, and the BCIU. It is a really collaborative effort to bring. We have 1,730 pieces of art down in the gallery, which I think is amazing. So I think we should give that a round of applause. And so now it is my pleasure to turn it over to Barry Benikoff and Paula Conroe, sorry. They are going to be handing out the awards for the Reading Berks Guild of Craftsmen. There you go.
Thank you all for coming out today. This is always an honor for me. We've been doing this, I think, since BCIU moved here. And it's great. We've been partners with GoggleWorks since they opened. It's really a great situation. And also, winners, you're invited to our November holiday show at Kutztown University. You check our website at rbcrafts.org. Get your information to Paula, our education chair, and we will contact you about setting up in the student gallery for free. We will mentor you on selling your items. It's a great event. So, and now I'll get started. First one will be the Burkhardt Gerhardt Award. It's for Mo Curry from Exeter School District. Next one is Cindy Kuhn from Twin Valley for the Hedwig Miller. Adriana Madden from Schuylkill Valley School District, Ruth Ann Hartung Two Dimensional Award. Josh Gonzalez from Reading Muhlenberg, the Witt Ladder Award for Best Traditional Work. Caroline Lowe, Twin Valley School District, Richard Loper Memorial Award. Emily Bray, Kutztown School District, Stanley Seltz Award for Outstanding Achievement in Design and Craftsmanship. Mia Davis, Daniel Boone School District, Stanley Stelz Award for Outstanding Achievement in Design and Craftsmanship. For Fine Arts, Monica Statton, Exeter School District, first place. For Crafts, Chad Endy, Boyertown School District, first place. Digital Design, Megan Pasco, BCTC, first place. Awards of Merit, Ella Cobberger, Daniel Boone School District. Chris Armbuster, Wilson School District. Serena Thompson, Twin Valley School District. And thank you all.
And next, I would like to invite Amanda East and Justin Heimelberger up from the Berks Arts. They are going to get out the First Lane Awards as well as their specific awards.
My name is Amanda East. I'm the Community Programs Manager at Berks Arts. Berks Arts is a nonprofit organization based right here in downtown Reading. We have a mission to inspire, engage, and unite our community through the arts. In addition to our grant making, scholarship, and music festivals, like the 10-day Berks Jazz Fest that's happening right now, all across the area, we are proud to partner with the educators across this county for music and art education initiatives, including a partnership with BCIU, which we call Fastlane Art. Fastlane Art is a celebration of art education and public art. A selection committee chooses artistic creations from the exhibit downstairs and then works with area businesses, property owners, universities, hotels, hospitals, and municipalities to transform these artistic works into large-scale public displays. You may currently see examples of these at the Doubletree Hotel on Penn Street, Alvernia College Town, BCTV, and Starbucks at 4th and Penn, in the cafeteria at St. Joseph's Medical Center, and on many other local businesses across the region. All of those winners that we announced today, your artwork will be photographed professionally so that we can turn your artwork into these public art displays over the next few months. Most recently, thanks to a new partnership with Fastlane Art's dedicated title sponsor, Lamar Advertising, you can now see this work displayed on digital billboards across the region. Look for those to pop up starting April 15th, next Monday, week from tomorrow. We are thrilled to announce the students this year who have had pieces selected for this program. From Antietam School District, Bianca Beckford and Kay Storms. Oh, and Karen Rosenberg, sorry. From Brandywine Heights, Angelina DeChristopher and Taylor Merkel. From Boyertown, Skylar Gilbert and Abigail Crick. From BCTC, Jordan Sayers and Tayson Merkel. From Conrad Weiser, Avery Reinhold and Taylor Raybould. From Daniel Boone, Maddie Haynes and Mia Davis. From Exeter Township, Rochelle Tualdo, Gianna Groff and Andrew Gill. From Fleetwood area, Sophie Toucher, Kayla Laus. From Governor Mifflin, Kay Bowman, Kai Bowman, sorry, and Ruby Rensler Groff. From Hamburg, Haley Edwards and Nahayami Runzer. From King's Academy, Abigail Lee. From Kutztown area, Torianne Betancourt and Emily Bray. From Muhlenberg, Jalen Rodriguez and Laris Bell Diaz. From Ole Valley, Carly Schaefer and Rich Hardington. From Reading Muhlenberg, CTC, Tatiana Brown and Marion Moran Urena. From Reading School District, Alicia Cordova and Olivia Carabello. From Schuylkill Valley, Adriana Madden and Scarlett Grosselfinger. From Tulpehocken area, Chloe Heckman and Zoe Smith, and Chris Lighty de la Cruz Maria. From Twin Valley, Caroline Lowe's, Ava Hartman, and Abby Clipsham. From Wilson, Lisette Rivera Romero and Ella Damiani. And from Wyomissing area, Madeline Price and Olivia Zor. and our prize winners from the collection are honorable mention goes to Chris Lighty de la Cruz Mejia from Topahawken. In third place, Abigail Lee from Cadence Academy. In second place, Kay Storms from Antietam. And then we have two memorial awards, the Alma Woods Memorial Award going to Mia Davis from Daniel Boone. And the Jack Coggins Memorial Award going to Nahaimi Runzer from Hamburg.
All right, let's give one more round of applause for all of the Berks Arts Award winners. All right, we are going to move into the awards that are given out from the Berks County Intermediate Unit. We provide first, second, and third, and then depending on the number of pieces in that artwork, we do a percentage of honorable mentions. So for our students winning in these categories, there's 18 of them. We ask that you hold your applause to the end of that category, and students, when you come up after you've received your award, we're going to stand across the front here, and then we'll do one big applause at the end of the category. So for our first and, I almost skipped one. The BCIU also does a permanent collection, and this piece is selected to be displayed in the Berks County Intermediate Unit in our main office in the hallway. And this year, our winner is Monica Statian from Exeter Township School District. All right, now for our biggest category is our oils and acrylics. So for our first place, we have Claire Roth from Fleetwood Area School District. Second place is going to Brooke Schaefer from Ole Valley School District. Third place is going to Chris Lighty, De La Cruz Meja from Topahawken Area School District. All right, round of applause. Moving into our next category, we have water media. First place is going out to Trinity Ramos from Muhlenberg School District. Second place going to Kay Storms from Antietam. Third place going to Gabrielle Brown from Daniel Boone. In our next category, we have color drawing. First place is going to Caroline Ikawazi from Conrad Weiser Area School District. Second place going to Olivia Spitz from Exeter Township. Third place for Emily Bray, Kutztown Area. And that is all for our color drawing. For our black and white drawing category, first place is going to Kai Couch from Twin Valley. Second place going to Carla Rodriguez from Reading School District. Third place for Thomas Elliott Albright from Wilson School District. I think that's for black and white. And moving into our pen and ink drawing, we have a first place going to Adriana Madden from Schuylkill Valley. Second place going to Devin Hartman from Fleetwood Area. Third place going to Mia Davis from Daniel Boone Area. Congratulations. Next category is printmaking. Our first place goes to Tony Ann Betancourt from Kutztown Area. Second place going to Dylan Glenn from Kutztown Area. Third place going to Willow Fester from Twin Valley School District. Our next category is mixed media and collage. First place going to Emily Bray from Kutztown Area School District. Second place going to Tony Ann Betancourt from Kutztown Area School District. Third place going to Isabella Birch from Schuylkill Valley School District. Next category is black and white photography. First place going to Dan Lee from RMCTC. Second place going to Owen Achenbach from Conrad Weiser Area. Third place going to Otis Engel from Kutztown Area. In our color photography category, our first place winner is going to Sandra Medina from RMCTC. We have second place going to Hannah Wojewski from BCTC. I apologize if I said that name wrong. Third place going to Olivia Soar from Wyomissing area. Congratulations. In our next category, we have digital and photo illustration. First place going to Megan Pasco from Conrad Weiser area. Second place also going to Megan Pasco, but it says BCTC. And then third place is Elizabeth Boding from RMCTC. Congratulations. Our next category is graphic design. First place goes to Chase Hickey from Governor Mifflin School District. Second is place goes to Haley Lupo from BCTC. Third place goes to Diamond De Jesus, RMCTC. Our next category is sculpture. We have a first place going to Peyton Lady from Wyomissing area. Second place for Sabrina Sade from Wilson School District. Third place for Tavish Rickard from Daniel Boone area. Congratulations to our sculptures. Our next category is textiles non-loom. First place going to Adriana Rivera from Schuylkill Valley. Second place for Chloe Weber, Daniel Boone area. Third place for Angelica Capuan Yafante from Reading School District. Congratulations. In our hand-built pottery category, we have a first place going to Chris Lighty De La Cruz Meja from Tobahawken area. Second place for Lucas Southerly from Tobahawken area. Third place for Kenley Golob from Governor Mifflin. Okay, congratulations. Our next category is Wheel from Pottery. First place going to Chad Endy from Boyertown area. A second place going to Zach Hook from Boyertown area. Third place going to Chad Endy again from Boyertown area. Our next category is digital art 3D motion and graphics. Our first place winner is Micah Andrews from Ole Valley. And the second place for this category goes to Devin Upshaw from Daniel Boone area. In our next category is NOTA, which is an open category. Our first place winner is Vivian Lovejoy from Twin Valley School District. Second place goes to Cameron Hetrick from RMCTC. Third place goes to Cooper Biscup from Daniel Boone area. I do apologize. I must have hit the button too fast, and I missed a textiles loom category, so I do apologize. First place for this category goes to Gabriella Linderman from Fleetwood area. Second place is going to Morgan Lothar from Fleetwood area. And third place is Denise Tavarez from Reading School District. And that concludes the award ceremony. I want to take the time to say thank you so much for coming out and spending the afternoon with us. But now is the time to go down and walk through and enjoy the 1,730 pieces of artwork from all of the districts here in Berks County. And we look forward to seeing you downstairs. Thank you.
I'm here talking with
Adriana Madden.
And what school district are you with?
Schuylkill Valley.
I have your wonderful piece up here. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
So I started working on this last school year in June, and it was for our Drain the Pen project. We're supposed to empty the entire pen. So I had two projects to for 1 week, and I had to scramble around over Memorial Day weekend, and I finished this in about 3 days.
And there's so much going on here too. This is gorgeous. I like the idea. I like the idea of the like finish the pen project. That's really interesting. So are you a senior this year?
Yes, I am a senior.
Are you looking to do art in the future at college or for a career?
Yes, I want to go to Kutztown University to be an art teacher, like my mom and like my grandmother.
Oh, that's wonderful. I also went to Kutztown for art education. I'm also an art teacher, so I happen to say it's a great school, so that would be awesome for you. All right. Anything else you want to say?
No, thank you.
All right, thank you. Hi, I'm here with Josh Gonzalez, and you're a senior this year?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you looking to do more art in the future, like for a career, for college?
Yes, I actually plan on doing that.
How long have you been working with metal? This is a beautiful sculpture here.
I'm a third-year Reading Muhlenberg CTC, and I've been, for 3 years now, I've been doing this for...
That's wonderful. I work with metal, too, a little bit, more with enamel and glass, but this is gorgeous. How long did it take you to make these flowers?
Actually, about 8 hours to make. Yes, my instructor was helping me out with it, everything, and props to him. He was the one who gave me the idea for it, and my dad as well.
Well, it's gorgeous, and congratulations on our Wib Louder Award, and I think you did a fantastic job.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with
Adriana Rivera.
And what school district are you with?
I'm with Schuylkill Valley School District.
And are you a senior this year?
Yes.
Can you tell me about this dress that you made?
So this dress was for my high school play this year, The Little Mermaid. So this was Ariel's pink dress.
How long have you been working with fabric and sewing?
Well, I've been working since I was a little girl. When my mom first taught me how to hand sew, I would practice on paper towels. I would color them and sew them together.
Wow, that must have taken some dedication too.
Yeah.
Well, that's wonderful. Do you have any plans for working with fabrics or fashion for the future for college?
Yeah, so I'm actually going to be attending Albright College for fashion and design.
Oh, fabulous. Well, great work here, and good luck in the future.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with
Isabella Birch.
And what school district are you with?
Schuylkill Valley.
All right. And are you a senior this year?
No, I'm a junior.
Ooh, a junior. Can you tell me about this piece that's right here?
This is inspired by Botticelli's Primavera painting. I was originally assigned to do just a three-dimensional, collage work, and the only restrictions I had was just the size of the paper, and I was inspired by the large section of leaves in the original painting. About the top third or so of the painting is just leaves, and I wanted to make something that featured real leaves.
Well, the leaves are gorgeous, and the way that you did the canopy is beautiful, and you are a junior, so do you think we'll be seeing some more collage pieces from you here next year?
Collage is actually not my typical medium. Usually I draw in hyper-realistic color drawing and black and white drawing, but this was a lot of fun and I'm really happy with the outcome, especially for my first time kind of exploring the medium.
Wow, being the first time exploring, you did a fantastic job. Well, I look forward to seeing your work then next year. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hi, we're here with Emily Bray, and what school district are you with?
I'm with Kutztown Area High School.
Your work is amazing. There's so many pieces here to look at. What's your favorite media to work with?
I definitely work with a lot of wide variety, but I really like colored pencil and oil paint, pen and ink, stuff like that. So.
Awesome. So are you a senior in high school?
Yeah, I'm a senior.
Okay. Are you looking to continue art as a career, going to school for art?
I'm actually looking to become a tattoo artist, so I am starting my tattoo apprenticeship hopefully this summer. Yeah, it's very exciting.
That's awesome, and I noticed that you had an awesome tattoo there on your elbow, so that's really exciting. I'm glad to hear that. So we look forward to seeing some other work from you in the future, and you'll have to let us know if you have your tattoo shop somewhere later. All right, thank you.
Yeah.
I am here with
Grace Grimm.
And what school district are you with and what grade are you in?
Schuylkill Valley in 11th.
11th. Okay. Can you tell me about this awesome piece here?
It's a mixed media piece of Van Gogh's self-portrait. And I used a bunch of different materials like glass beads and yarn. And those are flowers.
What did you use for his ear?
Clay.
Oh, so you built a clay piece for the ear. So some of these are found materials and some are some pieces that you've made?
Yeah.
Do you like to work in mixed media a lot, or do you have a preferred media that you like to use?
I like to do a little bit of everything.
Okay. Excellent. Are you planning on continuing with art after you get out of school? I know you're only in 11th grade, but are you thinking about it?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you think maybe we'll see some pieces from you here next year?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you. And I'm here with?
Del Althaus.
And what school district and grade are you in?
Muhlenberg, 12th.
All right. Can you tell me a bit about this piece here?
This piece was generally more of a character design study. I'm mainly focused on character design and animation with my pieces, but it was more about exploring feelings and trying out a new sketchier style to try and expand my works.
And this is a digital piece. Do you normally work with digital media?
I mainly focus on digital media. One of my pieces this year is watercolor for my AP Studio portfolio, but a lot of it is digital.
Awesome. And I love all the colors, the bright, bold designs, and I can definitely tell that you're working on characters because I think you have a couple other digital pieces here too that are beautiful character designs. Are you planning on doing anything with art for your career in the future?
Yes, I've already been accepted into my top choice school, and I'm planning to go for animation and game design.
Oh, fabulous. Well, good luck to you, and I hope to see your work in the future.
Thank you so much.
I'm here with?
Naomi Renzer.
And what school district and grade are you in?
I'm in 12th grade, and my school district is Hamburg Area High School.
Okay, and we're talking about your beautiful piece down here. Can you tell us a little bit about your piece that was submitted?
So I did this a while back in the beginning of school, and how I really, really got the inspiration was that it just came to me where I look at the stars, and I just thought of this woman, and I just started drawing it digitally, straight from my phone, actually.
Oh, wow. So you were inspired by what you were seeing around you. I think there's a lot of emotion in this piece. I love how she looks like she's glowing. It's a gorgeous piece. Are you thinking about doing something with art in the future for school?
Yes, I am planning for, like, once I graduate is to go to college and to focus on more digital art.
Oh, well, fabulous. Well, good luck to you. This is gorgeous work.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I'm here with
Cindy Kuhn.
And what school district and grade are you in?
I'm a senior at Twin Valley High School.
Okay, and we were just talking about how much buzz there is about your piece here. Can you tell us a little bit about what's going on here?
Oh, well, it's a big mixed media piece. I used a lot of upcycling, different materials and fabrics that I found around, just kind of made do with what I had. So it was about like 5 months of my time, just doing different stitches, felting. I learned a lot of new techniques, so it was a lot of fun for me, and I'm glad with how it turned out.
Oh, I know. It's gorgeous. It's eye-catching. You can see it from across the gallery. Draws people over. Are you thinking about doing anything with fabrics, textiles, art for college, or maybe a hobby in the future?
It's definitely going to be my hobby for life. Embroidering, felting, big thing for me, but I think I'd probably keep it as a hobby. I'm not too sure if that's what I'd go career-wise with myself, but still something I'd love to do.
Of course, you can still keep making amazing pieces regardless of what you choose to do in the future. So good luck to you, and again, this is an amazing piece. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. It means so much to me.
Awesome. I'm here with
Monica Stratton.
And what school district are you with and what grade?
I'm from Exeter Township Senior High School in 10th grade.
Wow, 10th grader. So can you tell me a bit about your piece here?
So we have an assignment in our class in which we draw a bug, and I chose a Buckeye butterfly because I knew I wanted to do a butterfly, but I didn't want it to be like a colorful butterfly, if that makes sense. I wanted to choose a brown one and then have like a more colorful background. And so it's a Buckeye butterfly with orange blossoms in the back.
It's gorgeous, and your attention to detail, the realistic nature of this drawing, it is just amazing. And you said you have several other pieces over here too?
Yes, I do.
Awesome. So you're only in 10th grade. Does this mean that we'll be seeing your work back here in the future?
Probably.
Okay. What's your favorite media to work in? Is it colored pencils like this one?
I guess I enjoy all forms of media, but I really like painting with like watercolor and stuff.
Okay. All right. Excellent. Thank you for taking some time to talk to us, and congratulations on your awards for this piece. It's gorgeous.
Thank you.
I am here with
Mo Curry.
And we are talking about your lovely piece here, but first, what school are you at and what grade?
I'm from Exeter High School. I'm an 11th grader going into 12th.
Okay, excellent. So tell me a little bit about this piece here.
So it's a project that we had to do. It's a green man mask, and then I used a very naturistic theme, and I took my mom's and my dad's favorite flowers, and I added them to the piece that are it's a stargazer lily and a snapdragon, and I used purple extra purple lavender to give a good pop from the yellow honey dripping from the head.
Oh, that makes sense. That's so beautiful that you included things from your parents in this too. And you have, you said these two pieces are here as yours as well?
This was a free piece because I had too much extra time, and I handmade this heart from, originally I used a pinch pop method into slowly adding on to each vessel. And then I used, this was my last piece I ever made in ceramics class. Hopefully I do more ceramics, but it's a Chinese method where I purposely broke it and put in, glued it back together and put gold leaf inside to give it this cool effect.
That's very dramatic. All right. Well, gorgeous work and congratulations. You're 11th grade, so could we see you back here next year?
Yes, hopefully with more 2D art and with my portfolio I'm planning to make about phobias.
Ooh, interesting. I love the topic. Well, I can't wait to see it. Thank you again.
Thank you. Lovely talking with you.
Thank you. You too. I'm here with
Rochelle Tawaldo.
And what school district and grade level are you in?
I go to Exeter Township, and I'm in 11th grade.
Excellent. Oh, 11th grade. So can you tell me a little bit about this assignment and this piece?
Yeah, we were just told to make a self-portrait, and I didn't want to just make, like, a generic one. I wanted it to be kind of, like, a little bit different. And I had a picture of myself from when I went to the beach, and it was, like, such a bright, funny, sunny day outside. And I thought that that would be a good one to do because it's a little bit different and a lot of textures in the hair and everything.
And that's what definitely caught our eye, all the textures, the attitude about it, and just the fine detail that's in here. It's amazing. What's your favorite media to work with?
I like just black and white drawing with a normal pencil, and I also like acrylic paint a lot.
Excellent. And so you're 11th grade, so could we possibly see some of your work back here next year?
Yes, definitely. I hope so.
Excellent. All right. Congratulations and thank you.
Thank you. Nice speaking with you.
You too. I'm Paula Conroe, and I wanted to thank you for joining us on Your Berks Craftsman here at the 42nd Annual Secondary Student Art Awards.